Sonia and myself decided to marry on May the 1st, 1945. We went back to the kibbutz. And in 1947, no one year after our first child, Ben-Gurion decided to call me to the headquarters of the Haganah, of the underground. He felt that we are going to have a war. It came to me as a surprise. I didn't want to make a military career. He didn't speak to me. Actually, when I was a young man, I wanted to be either a poet or an architect. Either to build from stones or to build from words. I thought building is a great opportunity. It is a good combination between imagination, creativity, and precision. Neither of the two came true. And actually, I went to the headquarters of the Haganah totally unprepared. The first time we met was in a winterly day. And he offered to me that he will take me on his trip from Tel Aviv to Haifa. I was very excited. For me, it was the legend of my life. I thought, oh my God, now I'm going to have 2 hours alone with Ben-Gurion. I shouldn't be able to talk with him. But he turned the back to me, forgot me completely. I was sitting so disappointed, you know, I thought, here's my dream disappearing. Only when we came rather near to Haifa, he turned to me and he says, you know, Trotsky was never a great leader. How did Trotsky enter the car on that voyage? I don't know this very day. But I wanted really to develop a conversation. So I asked, why? He said, what sort of a leader is he? No peace, no war. He says, this is a Jewish invention. A leader must decide either war and take the risk, or peace and pay the price. He says, Lenin was intellectually inferior to Trotsky, made the decision, so he became the leader. The conclusion is clear. Leaders have to make decisions. Then I asked Ben-Gurion, tell me, when did you feel yourself as a leader? He says, when I looked around and I didn't find anybody that I can ask a question, that I have to provide answers.